Michael Nagy here with KJAG TV, and I'm here with Laz Pina. How are you doing today?
How are you, my brother? How are you feeling?
Doing good. So, you want to tell us a little bit about yourself and the band?
Laz Pina, bass player for the Latino metal group Ill Nino, self-proclaimed kings of Latin metal. I've been doing this stuff for, I don't know, many years now, and a bunch of records and a bunch of travels leading us to where we're at right now. And we're actually here in the home of Ill Nino, which is Soundworks Studios, and our newly built soundstage, the Cyclorama. Welcome to our
awesome studio. I'm telling you, this is awesome. So how long have you been playing bass for?
I started playing bass when I was 15 years old.
Okay,
you know,
cool.
I think my dad had picked me up a bass. I was really just trying to like follow the lead. My oldest brother was had a guitar. You know, my second oldest, you know, wanted to play drums. The only thing left to be in the band was bass. So I freaking begged my dad to pick me a bass guitar, which I knew then. I mean, there's four kids in the household, and you know, I knew it was a big sack. I didn't understand how big a sacrifice, but my dad kind of, you know, wanted to like reassure that I would play. I promised him that I would always play bass. And you know, that's
there it is,
years ago. I'm still playing bass, I'm still playing music, and I surround myself around the arts.
Cool. So how did you get hooked up with Ill Nino? How'd that happen?
My buddy Dave Shavari, who I met when I was in a younger band when I was in high school called Brunhilda, and he was in a band called Gothic Slam. We met in the club circuit. Became friends, and his band got signed. He went on to play with other bands like Propane, MOD, Soulfly, Marauder. And you know, he'd always come back home looking to put his own band together. And this was one of those, this was the last band that he put together during that time period of putting a band together between gigs, because he was just done with, you know, being a hired gun. So he dug up, you know, all of his friends, you know, and he was recording. I just started a recording studio, and let him come up and to record his new project, Ill Nino, and that's how it all began. You know.
Cool.
I started with a audition with a cat named Jorge Rosado from the group Marauder, who's a terrific frontman, singer, lyricist, stylist. A very tough cat too,
right?
And it was more of a New York hardcore Latino kind of brand for the music when he was in the band. It was a dope band.
Cool.
It was an incredible band, but you know, things didn't work out. He went back to do his Marauder thing, which to this day he's still rocking house. And we it's a mosquito in the gym. It's so cold in here. But anyway, just giving you the history since you asked, you know.
It's good to know.
I thought you might have known that already. So.
Well, the viewers don't know that. I want to get the viewers to decide.
Yeah, okay, wonderful. So after that, you know, it was just, you know, demos that were being done. It was like, you know, throw in a bass line, you know, do a show. And the band got signed after three shows. Everyone was, you know, and this was a side project. I was still playing with my brothers. So, you know, for all of us, you know, it was very exciting times.
Yeah. Cool.
And Dave Shavari, my awesome bro to this day, who, you know, we're closer than ever. And I love his family dearly, and he loves mine. I'm also godfather for his daughter. And, you know, I'm just blessed to be able to say it's been now 18 years.
Wow.
Which is an incredible one.
That's incredible. Yeah, what do you think has kept the band together that long? I mean, a lot of bands, you know, don't last that long, so.
I don't know, to be quite honest. I never thought it'd last this long, you know? I thought it was going to be one record, you know?
Really?
Well, I was, you know, at that time, you know, it came late. I had already been playing in the underground music for 15 years. I was 15, I was like 30, you know?
I mean, your first record, you know, it's massive, so. Put you way up there.
Yeah, I mean, listen, at that time, I wasn't even really playing metal at that time. I was more cool side project to keep busy with and, you know, do some gigs. And it was way more than that, more than I burned. So I never took anything for granted. Mm-hmm. Everything was, you know, I'm very grateful for every moment that I had and shared with my bandmates, you know, and including the ones in the past that are no longer in the band. You know, they're all a part of this beautiful history. And, you know, I can't knock it. I love it.
Cool.
I'm ready for the next chapter.
What is the next chapter? What are you guys currently working on?
Right now, the band is kind of like taking a few months of hiatus. Christian, my lead singer, had some back issues and had to go into surgery and rehabilitation. But he's doing much better now. He was here actually producing a very talented friend of ours who was also came out of our doors at our studio, Chris Coretta from the group Monuments. And, got to, kick it here for a good 2 months, catch up and, think about our direction.
Cool.
So, there is music in the works, in thought. Well, right now we're on hiatus. Dave is also in a terrific band that is a side project called Terror Universal. Mm-hmm. And he is currently on tour right now with a new album.
Cool.
And the rest of my bros are just, doing, the same things that I'm doing. We all got our own projects.
Yeah. And eventually we'll come back together.
Yeah.
I teamed up with a couple shows and just see what happens.
I teamed up with for sure we're going to link up later in the year and start writing the new record.
Cool.
To release something by next, probably at the, there's so many variety of ways of doing it these days, but definitely something next year.
Do you have any ideas for that record? Because I know some of your newer stuff got a little heavier and stuff, because we haven't had the melodic melodies, and some of your newer stuff is pretty heavy, so I didn't know where you were going now with that kind of direction.
To us, I think it always differs from album to album. We begin to start just getting on the same page of things, and when it manifests, when we get into the studio, it's usually where, that's when you stick the electric charge into Frankenstein and it comes to life.
That's awesome.
Yes. So, that's going to be fun. But in the meantime, also doing a bunch of other things right now.
Yeah. You got this whole studio. You want to tell them a little about that, what you're doing here?
We're actually celebrating the 10-year anniversary at our Soundboard Studios in Hoboken.
Oh, wow.
We started here with 4 rooms.
It's a lot bigger than 4 rooms
10
now.
Years ago, what felt like, just the other day, and it's the whole floor now, including our latest studio, which we're sitting in right now, called the Cyclorama here in Hoboken, New Jersey, where we've been, shooting an array of music videos, commercials, models, everything that, can get shot on this infinity wall here, which trips you out when you look and trips me out.
Yeah, right? This is a nice place.
So we're thrilled to do a lot of other projects here. We want to go live and do a Sound Wars live stream concert on the stage, let the whole world sing simultaneously and make it interactive. We're going to have Q&As.
That's cool.
Songs, take requests, and make it a real personal live event over the internet.
Yeah, I see you got some events coming up here and stuff, and parties and stuff.
Yes. August 31st, we are hosting here the Rock Foundation. A dear friend of ours, photographer, terrific photographer, has been photographing the band and all the bands that have been coming out here throughout the last 10 years. She is the photographer, for the event, which is featuring, some testimonies from artists who are suffering from depression or are thinking about suicide. And I believe that is happening during suicide week, which, it's good to take time, and I wish it could be suicide week every day so we know whenever it goes to that, to that level. But, it's trying to motivate people. Featured in the show will be artists like Jonathan Davis from Korn, of course Christian Machado from Ill Nino, Randy Blythe from Lamb of God, Tommy Vex, Bad Wolves.
Cool.
Yeah, we have Corey Taylor from Spin and Sound and Stone Sour. Cool. So it's going to be a terrific event.
That's
all
awesome.
Here. It's all for charity.
Cool.
You know, we'll be selling these huge prints for each artist. Testimony. DMC from the New Zealand is also
featured. Wow. It'll be a big event.
Yes. Yes.
Cool.
Yes.
Awesome.
So, you know, we're looking forward to that.
Cool, cool.
So, what? Low battery power.
So, if people want to look you up online, like Ill Nino or yourself, how do they do that?
Well, you can find us, you know, you can find Ill Nino on all the respected sites, you know, the social sites on Facebook, just Ill Nino, and also on Instagram. You can find me with Laz Pina on both Facebook and Instagram. You can find Sound Wars Studios on Instagram. And you can also find the Cyclorama here on Instagram and on Facebook.
Cool.
So, awesome. You know, I guess those become like the most, you know, easiest way to reach bands these days. But yeah, check us out. Check out some of the pictures. And,
cool.
You know, if you're interested, you know, come partake in a wonderful space with some wonderful vibes and wonderful people.
Exactly. Well, it's good talking to you.
Likewise, likewise. Oh, one more thing before the battery runs out. Because I'm doing so much thing. I also started a management company with one of my dearest friends. We had a record company years ago. We played music together called GNO All Stars, Gordon Ansys. And we began to manage an old friend, a New York hardcore legend, Eddie Sutton. And his projects, which is Truth and Rights and Leeway. And we're in the middle of releasing some music from Eddie, and we're all very excited. A lot of great things are happening.
Cool.
So look out for some 45s if you're into New York hardcore.